I'm here at Apple Park and I just got demos of all the operating systems, but I want to focus on macOS Tahoe and specifically three of the biggest features. The Control Center, which is now completely customizable, the new Spotlight with clipboard history, shortcuts actions, and quick keys. I also saw some incredible examples using Mac automations, shortcuts, and Apple Intelligence, and we're going to get to that in a few minutes. First, let's start with Control Center. I didn't realize that the Control Center in macOS 26 Tahoe is basically a mimic of the iPhone and iPad Control Center. So now it's completely customizable, and you can even get third-party actions. If there are apps that use App Intents, like one of my favorite screenshotting tools, ShareShot, or apps like Bear and Things, you'll be able to add those actions to the Control Center on your Mac. And same thing with shortcuts. You can now add it to that Control Center. But not only that, you can also have multiple groupings of Control Center. So if you want a second page with your music controls and audio, you can have that in your menu bar, and you can create as many of those as you would like once you're in that edit mode. And I could also include several groupings of shortcuts from the menu bar. So previously, you know, the shortcuts just had that one icon in the menu bar. You can just add it to that one section. Well, now with that customizable Control Center, you can add multiple pages and include shortcuts, shortcut folders, and individual open app shortcuts. Yes, I'll be curious how many Matthew Casanelli puts in his menu bar. But this is definitely gonna help you clean up the look of that menu bar if you're gonna be using a lot of shortcuts, and it's gonna be a great place to activate them in addition to Spotlight, which there's huge changes to that as well. One of the first third-party utilities I always install on my Mac is a clipboard manager. I use PasteBot, so it has a history of all my clippings. Well, now Apple has built that into macOS 26 Tahoe. It's not immediately obvious how to get to the clipboard history, but you would do it by activating Spotlight with Command Space or clicking the magnifying glass in the menu bar, and then you would hit the right arrow key on your keyboard. That opens several menus, a quick app launcher, the quick keys and shortcuts actions menu, and your clipboard history. Now, an interesting tidbit about clipboard history. I assumed you would be able to set how many clippings you could save, maybe 100 or 500, but the clipboard history in macOS Tahoe is actually just an 8-hour history. So after 8 hours, your clippings will disappear from that built-in clipboard history. I thought all clipboard managers would be Sherlocked with this update in macOS Tahoe, but because you can't keep those clippings, which I have my PasteBot set to keep the last 500 clippings, this way I can search that entire history, which might go across several days, I'll probably continue using PasteBot for that reason. The built-in clipboard manager will be nice, especially for those who are new to it or have never used one, but it is not as powerful as those third-party utilities. Also, while Universal Clipboard is available across your Apple devices, something you copy on your iPhone doesn't automatically get put in the clipboard history on your Mac. You actually have to paste it on your Mac, and then it will go into the history. So it's not a running list of everything you've copied across all your Apple devices. It really is just on the Mac. So also in that Spotlight menu, you can have the quick app launching. You'll see them grouped by categories, but you can launch it how I do, which is just start typing an app name, hit return, and it'll open. But what's really powerful are the quick keys. There's over 100 built-in actions for quick keys, like sending a text message. So when you open Spotlight, you can type the letters SM, type a recipient and a message, hit enter, and never even open the Messages app and still send that message. Now you can customize the keyboard shortcuts for those quick keys. You would just click next to one of the actions and then type in what letter configuration you want. And App Intents do allow third-party apps to be a part of those quick keys as well. So creating a task in the Things app or creating a new note in Bear, technically those could be part of Spotlight as well. Now I asked if you could program a keyboard shortcut to launch a quick key without launching Spotlight first, and that's not the case. For any quick key action, you'll need to do Command Space or click the magnifying glass and then start typing the quick key. There's no keyboard shortcut to automatically go to that. Instead, a better option would be to use an actual shortcut, which you can program to a keyboard shortcut that you run anywhere. So while the built-in actions are great, like creating reminders, calendar events, books, sending messages and emails, what gets really powerful is running shortcuts from Spotlight. And it gets some superpowers here. For instance, if you want to run a shortcut based on a file, well, typically you might right-click on that file, choose the shortcut, and then it will use that file as the input. Well, now, if you have a Finder window open, and let's say you have multiple files selected, like multiple PDFs, well, if you open Spotlight and start running a shortcut, it will automatically use the selected files you had as the shortcut input. So no right-clicking, finding the share menu. You can literally select a bunch of files, Command Space, type a shortcut name, and the files you had selected will be used in whatever shortcut you're launching. That's going to be really powerful and allow you to do bulk actions quickly. And speaking of shortcuts, let's get to the new shortcuts automations that are now in macOS. I went through the list there in the demo area, and it has a lot of the automation triggers you would have on iOS and iPad, like time of day, when it's charging, connecting to Wi-Fi. But it also has things like when a display is connected or when an external drive is connected. So now you can connect an external SSD. Maybe you want to automatically open an app like Lightroom to import from there. Well, now you can create those automations on a Mac and run those shortcuts based on those triggers. When a display connects or disconnects is another automation trigger. So whether that's enabling Stage Manager or opening apps in multiple windows, tiling, or you can do all of that with the new automation actions. But the automation triggers that are really exciting is the watch folder commands and when files are modified or folders are modified. So typically I use the third-party utility Hazel, and I might still continue doing it because it has probably more powerful features than these automations. But now you can tell shortcuts on your Mac to watch a folder, say your downloads folder, and whenever something is added or changed in that folder, to take action. So for instance, maybe you want to create an automation that when a file is dropped on the desktop, it automatically moves to another folder, or it automatically gets renamed. Well, now you can do that with those automations. But what's really powerful is when you incorporate those folder actions with Apple Intelligence, because now you can say, when I drop a PDF in the downloads folder, automatically look at the content of that document, summarize it, and create a note based on that PDF. You can do that with these automations and Apple Intelligence shortcuts actions, which is pretty wild. And one of the most impressive demos I saw at Apple Park was using this organization with Apple Intelligence and looking in the content of files. So for instance, let's say you have 10 PDFs on your desktop. Well, you can run a shortcut that looks at all the documents on your desktop, looks at the contents or the text of those files, then uses Apple Intelligence to automatically sort those PDFs into folders that you predefine. So let's say the PDFs are about your vacation next week, or maybe it's PDFs about iOS 26. Well, it can move those automatically to folders that pertain to the topic. So if you never want to deal with files on your desktop again, you can now have shortcuts automations and Apple Intelligence automatically sort those files. Now again, you're gonna have to set up folders, the topics, what kind of things Apple Intelligence is looking for in the content of those documents, but it is an incredibly powerful tool. That is just the beginning. Organizing files and folders is one, but you can combine it with the transcribe audio action, and you can create an automation that says, anytime I drop an MP3 into my downloads folder, have shortcuts automatically transcribe it, and then have Apple Intelligence automatically summarize it and add that summary to an Apple note. You can do that now with all the built-in actions and Apple Intelligence. Or going back to documents or PDFs, if you want a summary of every document you drop on your desktop, you can create a shortcuts automation that does that. Also, if you have to deal with a lot of images, maybe you deal with WebPs and you want to convert them to JPEGs, well, you can create automations for that too. Anytime an image file is dropped on your desktop, automatically convert it to a JPEG and move it to a folder of your choice. That's the power of the Apple Intelligence and shortcuts automations. And the one action that I'm gonna have to spend a lot of time with is that model choosing action, because you can not only prompt Apple Intelligence with a custom prompt, use shortcut inputs, either from files you have selected and running Spotlight, or just using from the share menu. You can choose the local model, private cloud compute, or even ChatGPT, and that opens a lot of possibilities. So one of my workflows right now is, I typically export the video right at the end when I'm done editing as an MP3, I'll transcribe it using Transcriptionist, open that in TextEdit, copy and paste that text into ChatGPT with a text expander prompt. So ChatGPT gives me title, description, and tag ideas for that video. Well, that's 3 to 4 apps with multiple steps that I'm having to do manually. Now I can tell shortcuts to watch this folder whenever I export an MP3 of one of my videos to automatically transcribe it, then ask Apple Intelligence with a prompt for the same title, description, and tag ideas for YouTube and the last version of macOS. So this is gonna open a ton of possibilities. I'm gonna be doing lots of advanced shortcuts. So subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, leave comments below this video. I'm gonna answer those personally. Also, it's my last day at Apple Park. Had one more briefing today and really excited to cover iPadOS beta in another video. So again, keep your eye on the channel. Hit that like button, questions below. Also, I'll put my total recap of the WW keynote right up here. And if you want to see the new Apple Intelligence shortcuts actions on iPhone, I have the iOS 26 beta on a 16E, and I went through and already built shortcuts using the new actions. I'll put that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.